Amidst the row of what had been decided by the central government on the issue of question hour for this monsoon session in Parliament. So the Lok Sabha Secretariat has now said it has decided to do away temporarily with the question hour, and this is of course because of the extraordinary COVID-19 situation, the extraordinary truncated monsoon session as well. He has further assured that the question hour will be back in the winter session. So it's not going to be happening right now. It would be back by the winter session. Hopefully, we will be in a much better situation as far as the COVID-19 crisis is concerned. The Secretariat also says that the government will be giving written replies to all the 160 unstarred questions per day in the upcoming session. We have with us Times Network's Samia Kapoor getting us those inputs here. So, Samia, this is not going to be a live question hour session, but they would be taking in those questions and they would be giving written replies. So, there's this time for those written replies and it's all going to be on text. It's not going to be caught live in session. It's not going to be caught across national television then.
Well, absolutely. And this has been the foremost demand of the opposition party to ensure that the question hour is not done away with. It's a parliamentary practice that has been going on for decades as a norm. To do away with question hour would be doing away with the rights of the MPs to raise questions that range from district levels to those of national significance. And they have been wanting to raise questions as far as the coronavirus outbreak is concerned, the health infrastructure, the migrant workers, the Chinese clashes, and of course, the economy slump. But as far as the written replies are concerned, this is not something new that is being introduced by the government of the day. There has always been a practice of also having questions replied in written form. But what the opposition parties want is that the question should be taken live in the floor of the House before the minister concerned of those particular ministries to be held responsible and answerable for the questions that the MPs want to raise. And so that these questions can be placed on record live on television for the entire country to see that the opposition party leaders are being the voice of the masses, asking those tough questions to the government of the day. But clearly, the government of the day has dug in their heels and they do not want to yield to the demands of the opposition party. We did see how Derek O'Brien, several of the TMC leaders and Congress leaders, Adhir Ranjan Chaudhary, wrote to the Speaker requesting them that the zero hour, the question hour and the private member's bill should not be done away with. That is definitely not going to be in the right spirit of democracy in the Parliament, that these should be allowed. They rather went on to say that even if it requires for them to extend the session, the opposition MPs would comply with. But the fact of the matter is that if you do not allow the question hour, do not allow the MPs to ask those questions to the government of the day and the ministers concerned, then the entire session would end up being a sham. The opposition party feels that it's only to bulldoze certain legislations that the government wants to pass. And the fact is that it's an attempt to muzzle the voices of the opposition who want to raise very crucial issues on the floor of the House and the Parliament.
That's right. So the government, of course, is still going ahead, but only with an assurance that the question hour is going to be back next winter session. Opposition, of course, has been demanding that it be maintained this session itself because there are several questions that the opposition wants to ask. Really stopping any questions. They will take in those questions in text, in print, and then given those written replies back within the duration of this session itself. Samia, thank you for getting us those inputs.